I have an incredible trick for you guys to reduce your tilt in League of Legends as well as in every other game where you might be tilting. Most people mess up their own games with their tilting and with their raging and therefore have a lower win rate just because they don't play mindfully. And by the end of this video, you will have all the tools you need in order to get completely tilt-proof. So let's start into this very interesting topic. My name is Mario and I'm trying to climb to Challenger in League of Legends. For the last 2 years, I've brought mindfulness into my life through meditating on a daily basis, through reading some books, through practicing and also visiting courses about mindfulness. And today I want to share this with you, how you can deal with tilt and become completely tilt-proof. First of all, you need to understand what happens in your body when you tilt. So what happens with your thoughts and your feelings, your emotions, and what happens? You have beliefs and thoughts in your head, so you think, okay, this was bad. Then there comes a feeling of feeling bad. I did this wrong, or my teammates did this wrong. You get a bad feeling. And from this feeling, you have an action. You tilt, you play bad, you do things you shouldn't actually do, you coin flip, maybe you just go on your enemy because you rage and want to kill him. And so this is the action you get from the feeling, and the feeling you get from the thoughts. And this happens within seconds, so you can't see this at first. And then in the end you have the result, which would maybe be you lose the game, maybe be you lose the fight, and then let's say you lose another fight, and then there come the beliefs and the thoughts again and say, okay, yeah, I already said I'm just bad, I can't play this game. Then you're feeling even worse, then you're playing even worse, and this is the circle. And this is how actually every emotion works, and how every action, emotion, thoughts, this is just how your body works. But today we will just discuss it on tilt, of course, because this is what you want to handle correctly, right? So now you maybe ask yourself, okay, but how do I become tilt-proof? How do I stop myself from tilting? And the answer actually is you don't stop yourself from tilting, because you can't stop yourself from tilting. The first step is you just recognize that, okay, there are thoughts coming. The thoughts, the negative thoughts are coming. Okay, the feeling is coming, the bad feeling about being bad or having bad teammates. And this is the first step, actually, and this is the most important step, to just recognize it, to just notice that there is now a program in your body, in your mind, which is you tilt. This is your tilting program, and to just see this from, so you take a step back and you watch yourself tilt, and you might not do it on the first time. What will maybe happen on the first time is you will just tilt like you always do, and then afterwards you know, okay, this is what actually happened. So you realize, okay, this is where my negative thoughts are arising, this is where my negative feelings are arising. And if you keep practicing this, you always will notice this a little bit earlier. And then if you do this a few times, if you do this a few days, weeks, if you practice this every time you tilt, there will be one point where you notice the negative feelings coming up, and the feeling just delays, so it arises and it goes away. So this would be if you are completely tilt-proof, but it's not the goal to become completely tilt-proof or to do this at the first time. The goal is to just take the step back and watch your feelings, watch your emotions, and just be the witness of your feelings and your thoughts. And this actually, you will notice if you take this step back and watch yourself having those feelings and those thoughts, you won't be affected by it. So that's already a release. You will already feel released, and then you already have better decision making because you are not the slave of your feelings and your thoughts. You don't identify with them, and then you don't fall into the habit of playing with aggression and playing from a state of rage, but you, because you stay mindful, you stay aware, you then can keep on playing good, keep on playing nice, don't coin flip, don't rage or do some bad decisions, because you, yeah, you won't be affected from your feelings and your thoughts. And yeah, I really wish you good luck with it, and I hope you try it, because it helped me so much getting better at the game, because I saw that most of the times when I started tilting, I was just coin flipping afterwards. I was just playing bad because I just wanted to somehow kill the enemy to make me feel better. So I wanted to force the win, but this is not how it works. And then you only, yeah, you destroy your own game. And so make sure to, yeah, stop doing this, and you will see, you will get better at the game. You can always also use this in your everyday life, because this works in every situation of your life, of course. And yeah, enjoy the process. Alright, so yeah, if you learned at least anything from this video, make sure to leave a thumbs up to support my channel. Comment down below, let me know what your current ranking is, because I really would like to hear that. And also remember, if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel, subscribe to my YouTube channel, subscribe to my Twitch. You can find the link in my YouTube channel. And also hit the notification bell, of course, so you won't miss any upcoming videos. I'm posting videos every Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday until I finally make it up to Challenger. That's my challenge. I want to share my road to Challenger with you guys and also help you the best I can, so you guys can climb just as well and reach the ranking you ever wanted to reach. And yeah, have fun at the game. So yeah, I'm signing out for today and see you guys in the next video. Bye.